Hello guys, welcome to another video of Pressy Writing sample papers. Basically, I have again compiled few samples from the Pressy Writing from that appeared in a previous examination. So we shall be discussing about each of them in detail now. So let's begin. So this is the first sample passage for which we'll write a Pressy, and we will understand the passage and then we will write a Pressy accordingly. So let's start with the passage right now. Okay. One of the pleasantest things in the world is going on a journey. So students, your first and foremost task is that while you are reading the passage, you should underline certain keywords, because these keywords will help you to that will lead you to a title of the passage. Okay, you can't get to the title unless you underline the keywords. Now we got our first keyword in the very first line, that one of the pleasantest things in the world is going on a journey, but I like to go by myself. I can enjoy society in a room, but out of doors, nature is company enough for me. I am then never less alone than when alone. I cannot see the wit of walking and talking at the same time. When I am in the country, I wish to vegetate like the country. I am not for criticizing hedgerows and black cattle. I go out of town in order to forget the town and all that is in it. There are those who for this purpose go to watering places and carry the metropolis with them. I like more elbow room and few encumbrances. I like solitude when I do not give myself up to it for the sake of solitude. Nor do I ask for a friend in my retreat. The soul of a journey is liberty. Okay, liberty means freedom. Perfect liberty to think, feel, and do just as one pleases. We go on a journey chiefly to be free of all inconveniences, to leave ourselves behind. It is because I want a little breathing space to music on different matters that I absent myself from the town for a while without feeling at a loss. That moment, I am left to myself. Instead of a friend to exchange the same stale topics over again, let me have a trace with this sort of impertinence. Give me the blue, clear blue sky over my head and the green turf beneath my feet, a winging road before me, and a 3 hours march to dinner and then to thinking. So now that we have understood the passage, it's time to understand the key headline. Basically, after reading all the passage, you got a heading. First of all, that it's all about a journey. Okay, the speaker is talking about journey to a different place, a trip to a different place. But in context of journey, he's talking about a journey which is made alone. Okay, he's telling you that I prefer going to a journey alone, because I feel when one goes to a journey, there is no point of taking anyone with you, and there is no point of those stale topics and talks and walks, etc. Instead, if you are going, I prefer that I should be as close to the nature as possible. All I need is a clear blue sky over my head and a green grass beneath my feet. Something like that he's telling. So without any doubt, our title can be going on a journey. Now I will give you some other suitable substitute titles that you can adopt. You can say a journey. Only you can write a title, a journey, or a soul journey. Soul means alone journey. Okay. A journey made alone. Something like that. So now you write the Pressy. Okay. Pressy of the passage. The passage was lengthy. Pressy has to be very brief. Now, while going on a journey, I like to go alone and enjoy the company of nature. So if you see the Pressy, they have written one of the pleasantest things in the world is going on a journey, but I like to go by myself. I can society in a room, but out of doors, nature is company enough for me. Now they have written two separate lengthy lines about it, that I like to go on a journey alone. I don't want to go with anybody. I want to be with nature completely. So same thing you have understood, Now, when you will write in your own word, you need not to write in two lines. Instead, you should cut short it in one line. That while going on a journey, I like to go alone and enjoy the company of nature. Or you can write, while going on a journey, I like to go alone without any friend, but in the company of nature. When I am in town, I wish to stay idle, but going out of town, I forget everything and enjoy my solitude without any friends. So this comes under this particular paragraph, which is of 4 to 5 lines. The lump sum idea about this particular paragraph is that the poet is telling that I can be alone in my city, but when I'm going out of my town, I like solitude. I like being alone. Okay. That's all you will write, that when I'm in town, I wish to stay idle, but when I'm going out of town, I forget everything and I enjoy my solitude even without my friends. My purpose of journey is liberty, perfect liberty to think, feel, and to just as one pleases. Despite any useless gossips, I love to have clear blue sky, green turf, a winging road, and a peace. Now they have said that give me a clear blue sky over my head. So over my head is again an extra point. So you can exclude that when you're writing a pressy, because you have to take only your major points. Okay. Then the green turf beneath my feet. So beneath my feet has been excluded because again, it is a secondary information. We have to focus on the primary information in the passage. A winging road and what? And a peace of mind, you can say. Okay. So this is the perfect pressy sample. Now we'll move to sample number 2. This is passage number 2. Let's start it. The world today is divided into smokers and non-smokers. The moment you read the first line of the passage, students, that moment only you get to the head, you get to the idea of the passage. So we got to know this whole passage will be about the smokers and non-smokers. Okay. It is true that smokers cause some nuisance to non-smokers, but this nuisance is physical, while the nuisance that non-smoker cause the smokers is spiritual. There are, of course, a lot of non-smokers who don't try to interfere with smokers, and wives can be trained even to tolerate their husbands smoking in bed. That is the surest sign of a happy and successful marriage. It is sometimes assumed, however, that non-smokers are morally superior, but have missed one of the greatest pleasures of mankind. I am always scared and ill at ease when I enter a house in which there are no ashtrays. The room is apt to be too clean and orderly. The cushions are apt to be in their right place and the people are apt to be correct and understood. And immediately I act on the best behavior, which means the same thing as the most thing behavior. So basically, this passage is a contradiction between the smoker's lifestyle and the lifestyle and psychology of non-smokers. Like a smoker sometimes creates nuisance to a non-smoker, but on the other hand, even a non-smoker causes a lot of disturbance to a smoker. So this is all the passage all about. Now let's jump to the pressy writing. And title is very simple to identify. The title will be Psychology of Smokers and Non-Smokers. You can also write the title that a contradiction between smokers and non-smokers, or you can write the title smokers versus non-smokers. Okay, these are some substitute options which you can write. Now there are two categories of people in the world that has already told to you. The word today is divided into smoker. Now you can write, there are two categories of people in the world. First is the one who smoke and the second who doesn't smoke or who does not. Where the smokers are affecting physically themselves and others by smoking, non-smokers are affecting themselves spiritually by not stopping them. Instead of being morally superior, they let them smoke in front of them for their pleasures. So this is where your pressy ends. You can add one more line if you want. But even if you write like this, we get an idea about what the passage is all about. Because pressy writing is nothing but they are just to tell you that basically you have to get a hint or gist of what is in the passage. Okay. So that's it. I hope you have understood this sample number 2. Now we'll move to sample number 3. Let's start with sample number 3 now. Let's start. This passage is quite long, but the precy is also according to that only, as I told you. So let's begin. India has witnessed great expansion of educational opportunities. Now you have to underline this word, educational opportunities, because this is where your whole passage is going to revolve. Since the attainment of the independence, however, the disabled children, okay, disabled children have not yet benefited in any substantial manner from the growth in educational facilities. Means educational opportunities have increased, but still children who are disabled have not been benefited completely. Education of handicapped children ultimately becomes more dependent and non-productive. It is therefore believed that scarce national resources should not be wasted on them. Further, it has been our misconceived notion that education of handicapped children requires highly specialized people, and as such, it must essentially be very costly. Maybe precisely for these wrong notions, we have not been able to involve clinical and educational specialization programmers of training in education, exclusively meant for handicapped children. That means there is a fixed notion in a lot of people's mind that the education of handicapped children will require highly specialized teachers and equipments that will cost a lot. And as a result, these are neglected. It is encouraging to note that new national policy on education has recommended the placement of such children in regular school, so as to provide them integrated education along with normal students. The integrated education will take care of different needs of various categories and types of disabled children. The objective is to place the disabled children in ordinary schools for imparting education with the help of special teachers, aides, and other resources. For fulfilling this objective, an area of necessary infrastructure by way of training of teachers, provision of equipment and book, etc., are some of the basic prerequisitions. Hopefully, the parents and their handicapped children will be greatly relieved when later are transferred to the regular school. That means this passage is divided into three categories. Students, if you identify, this is all about the education of disabled children or handicapped children. Initially, in the paragraph, they're told that we have grown in terms of education, but we have completely ignored the education of disabled children, thinking that it would be very costly. But our new education policy had given a different idea of education. They have introduced the system of integrated education, means these disabled children will also study in the normal and regular schools along with the normal students. Okay, this is a good step. So this is all the gist of the paragraph. Now let's start with the precy writing. And let's move on to it. So title is very simple, Inclusive Education for Children with Disability. Now title can vary. I am not saying that whatever title I've chosen, you have to go with so much like specific title, not at all. Inclusive education is a term which is used by the government to create a platform for disabled students to study from in the regular school, okay? So basically you can give another title. For example, you can write Education for Disabled. This can also be the title. Education for Disabled. Okay, so this can also be the title of your precy. The title can vary according to the demands of the passage. Let's read the precy now. Instead of expansion of educational opportunities in India, the disabled children have not yet benefited significantly. Now, this was our first line in the passage. We got our idea in the passage that despite of a lot of opportunities in the field of education, our disabled children are still not getting the benefits for that. Due to the belief that handicapped children are dependent and non-productive in their education, require highly specialized teachers, educational program for handicapped children have not been implemented. Now, secondly, we got a reason. I told you, paragraph was divided into three categories. Okay, the first one was that educational opportunities are there, but it has not benefited disabled children. Secondly, we focused on like that because these children require dependency and they're non-productive and their education require a lot of expenses. That's why people are not implementing over them. Now, our third passage, or third part of the passage, was that the new education policy recommends that such children should be placed in the regular schools where their needs are catered. However, to fulfill this objective, some prerequisites are to be done, okay? And hopefully this recommendation will give relief to the handicapped children. So that was all. That was all what I explained to you. And this explanation you have to write in the pressy writing. Okay, now let's move ahead to the another sample. Okay, the another sample is about discipline. From the name, from the beginning only you will understand. Discipline is one of the utmost importance in a student life. If the young students do not obey their superiors and go without discipline, they will be deprived to do much of their training they should have at this period, and the future they will never be able to extract obedience from their sin in society. Means discipline is very important in a student life. If they do not learn to be disciplined, in the future they will never learn to be obedient. Society will never accept them as the person fit for commanding and taking up any responsible position. Definitely in life, if you are not disciplined, you do not consider, you are not considered to be responsible. So in future, these people will not be given any responsible positions. Duty of all the students is to observe discipline in the preparatory stage of their life. A college without discipline can never impart suitable education, definitely. The rule of discipline in the playground and the battlefield as well as plays an important role. A team without discipline may not fare well in spite of good players. Now they have given an example that our team, which has a lot of good players, but there's no discipline, then that team will not be able to win the game. Okay, that's the point. In any army, everyone from the rank of general down to the rank of an ordinary soldier. Now, two examples they have given, an example of a team, and secondly, they have given an example of a soldier. In case a soldier does not obey his immediate superior, army becomes rabble, quite unfit. Okay, at first sight, it may appear to us that discipline takes away individual liberty, but on analysis, it is found that it does not do so, for liberty is not license. We find discipline, liberty at the root of all kind of human happiness. So at first, in the beginning, some people say that discipline means you are taking away the freedom of somebody. You are taking away the liberty of somebody. Okay, so at first people do think that discipline means you are restricting the freedom of a person, but it does not mean the same. Even if you're restricting the liberty of a person, however, a disciplined liberty is one such thing which is very important. So now the pressy has been understood. So the passage has been understood by you. I'll again tell you, the passage is also divided into three categories over here. In the first part, they have given that discipline is very important. In the second part, they have given examples of a team and a soldier. And then in the third part, they have looked into the fact that liberty is not like taken away in terms of discipline. So let's start. Now, over here, let's start with discipline is a building block of a student's life. Students start observing discipline from their superiors. It plays a very important role in person's life. Now, either in team or in a battlefield. Now, see, in the passage, we had very exaggerated examples. But in the pressy, you cannot take an exaggerated example. Instead, you can simply quote the examples like in the team or in a battlefield or as a life of soldier. It does not take away individual liberty at the root of all kind of human happiness. That's it. You covered all the three passages and three important things. The first one was, what is the discipline? How it is important? Second, two examples. And third, the liberty part covered. That's it. And the title is the importance of discipline. Title is very understood. You're talking about discipline and importance. How much it is important. You can also give example. You can also write in title like worth of discipline instead of importance of discipline. That is up to you. Now, let's start with the last sample. Let's begin now. I'm going in detail. I'm explaining you every single thing so that you get an idea how to understand the passage as well. Almost every country in the world believes that it has some special dispensation from Providence. That it is of a chosen people or race, and that others, whether they are good or bad, are somewhat inferior creatures. It is extraordinary. Now, this kind of feeling persists in all nations of East or as well as West without exception. The nations of the East are strongly entrenched in their own ideas and convictions and sometimes in their own sense of superiority about certain matters. Anyhow, in the course of the last 200 or 300 years, They have received many knocks on their head and they have been humiliated and they have been debased and they have been humiliated and they have been debased. Yeah, this is a repetition of the line, sorry. And they have been exploited. To some extent, this brought a sense of realism to them. Three was also an attempt to escape from reality by saying that it was sad and that we were not so advanced in material and technical things. But these all were, after all, superficial things. Nevertheless, we were superior in essential things in spiritual and moral values. I have no doubt that spiritual things and moral values are ultimately more important than other things. But the way one finds escape in the thought that one is spiritually superior simply because one is inferior in a material and physical sense is surprising. It does not follow by any means it is an escape from facing a cause of one's degradation. Now, this is a difficult passage, what I can say, because your idea is not getting very much clear from the passage, but I'll tell you a lump sum idea. Basically, we're talking about the countries in the world. The countries in the world are considering themselves superior, and on the other hand, they are considering the other countries inferior, okay? Because one country is good in itself, and the other country is bad, so they're considering a kind of comparison, okay? They're not accepting the fact that they are also inferior in some ways. So let's start with the particular, yeah. So let's start. Title can be a wide berth from acceptance, but you can choose a title that differentiation between countries, okay? Yeah, acceptance of realities, you can rock about like this. Now the passage, the pressy will be very simple. Every country in this world has some good things and with bad things. But surprisingly, they're not ready to face the reality of their inferiority by giving an excuse. If their superiority, like the East, which explained its inferiority in machines and technical things, of their superiority, it's spiritual things. So that is the lump sum pressy of the particular passage, that countries have some good things and some bad things. But the fact is that they're not ready to accept the reality of their inferiorities, rather they are giving excuses of their superiorities. Okay, so students, these are all the samples that we have discussed today. I hope you have understood how to write a good pressy. Pressy is nothing but your great understanding about the passage. The more better you understand your passage, the more better a pressy you can write in English grammar. Okay, so I hope you have understood, and in the coming lectures we'll take again more samples for your practice.